Hi, I'm Brianna Sullivan. I'm a senior director of product operations at Bandwidth, and I'm here to talk about Stir Shaken. There are between 4 and 5 billion robocalls made each month, and it's estimated that around 40% of those are fraudulent. That's nearly 2 billion illegal calls every month, or 5 calls for every person in the US. Because of this, Congress and the FCC are pushing for stricter caller ID authentication standards. This new framework, known as Stir Shaken, is designed to help reduce fraudulent robocalling and illegal number spoofing. I wanna cruise? Taken together with other tools, Stir Shaken can help restore trust in the calls that we receive. It also allows me to expense martinis with Bandwidth under market research. Stir stands for Secure Telephony Identity Revisited. Stir is a working group within the IETF, an internet standards body. They've created a set of protocols used to create a digital signature for a call, which includes information about the calling party. Stir also allows for verification of the signature by the terminating provider. Shaken stands for Secure Handling of Asserted Information Using Tokens. Shaken are the standards for how service providers should handle signed calls in their network. Let's look at how Stir Shaken works. When a call is made, a SIP invite is created. During an outbound call, a SIP invite is received by the originating, or from, service provider. The service provider looks at the source of the call and the calling number to determine how best to sign or attest based on the validity of the phone number. Attestation is also worth 11 points in Scrabble. There are 3 different levels of attestation. Full, or A attestation, means the service provider knows the customer and their right to use the phone number. Partial, or B attestation, means the provider knows the customer but not the source of the phone number. And gateway, or C attestation, means the service provider has originated the call onto the network but can't authenticate the call source. Using an authentication service, the originating service provider creates an encrypted SIP identity header that includes the calling number, the number being called, a current date and timestamp, the attestation level, and a unique origination identifier for traceback. Then the SIP invite, along with the SIP identity header, is sent to the terminating provider, who sends the SIP invite to a verification service. The verification service obtains the originating provider's digital certificate from a certificate repository. The SIP identity header is decrypted and compared to the SIP invite. Then the header signature is verified using the public key of the certificate from the certificate repository. If the call passes verification, then the terminating service provider either completes or blocks the call. Analytics engines look at attestation level and other factors in their decisioning process. See? Simple. All of this can get pretty complicated. So if you're not sure if you need to deploy Stir Shaken in your network, or you want to prevent bad traffic from reaching your network in the first place, Bandwidth can help. Every day, we're working to keep bad actors out of the ecosystem while helping to make sure that your valid traffic gets through. To find out more, contact your account manager or visit us online at bandwidth.com/stirshaken.